Every night, I met my wife in a dream. Because in real life, she died in a car accident. Elizabeth. I was so tired of this. The line between dreams and reality had become blurred. One of the dreams ended differently than normal, though, leaving a trail in my reality. I managed to draw one thing from that dream. And that is how it was. What a place. Is this my wife?
Set me free, and I'll set you free.
I thought it was just a ticket to the amusement park. But it happened to be the ticket to my new life. The park had changed, especially to greet me. It was like it was waiting for me to show up, clear of any witnesses, and with challenges prepared for me. I had no idea what these challenges were, and where they would lead me to. Well, looks like a haunted place. Reminds me of a hotel I once stayed in.
Wife is calling me, but the train is blocking the way.
Wow.
I must catch this photo, right here, right now.
I came round in the sky, almost. Night had been replaced by daylight. The park was just the same as before.
But there was a surprise to greet me on waking.
Of course I recognized our country house in the photo.
And I understood that something must be waiting for me there. If the post box escaped, it must be hiding something important. To follow her to reveal the mystery of my dreams.
Thank you.
GPS brought me to the past. I had not been there for a long time.
There was a garage that Elizabeth and I had inherited.
I felt a mix of fear and curiosity, expecting something to be behind its gates.
You have reached your destination.
Thank you.
I'll call up all these unusual obstacles on my way to the barrier.
Thank you.
The barrier was still here. The door was blocking my way, at the same time attracting me to its light, like a moth. It was obvious that no ordinary key was needed. I was so tired, and my inner voice begged me to sleep. That had become the solution I needed.
Whoa, 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 what happened? Am I shrinking?
I woke up, holding the very thing I needed to advance further. A few steps nearer to finding Elizabeth. I'm ready to overcome any of the barrier's attempts.
Thank you.
I ran after the ghost of my wife. I just couldn't stop. I came to a place I knew so well.
Hi, sweetie. I did recall this place when you brought me here for the first time. I feel as if an invisible wall or barrier prevents us from meeting. When I return to the places of our past, I feel that you are getting closer. I beg you to just keep moving forward so no barrier can stop you, and then we can meet again. Remember the place we met? You can come back, I know.
I realized we had been given a second chance to be together, and my dream became not so nightmarish. Elizabeth and I met in the dining room. I need to get there.
Thank you.
We met while working at this factory. She is waiting for me.
Do you recall the place we found in the prairie?
Elizabeth was talking about the lake we found once during a walk. For her, I was ready to walk along its bottom. My eyes were searching for some kind of sign, and I found it. Thank you. I hunted for another flashback. About the place I knew so well. Reaching it was all I had to do. This barrier blocked my way. I wasn't able to drive through it.
Thank you.
Suddenly, the barrier started to attack me and to destroy my reality. I was back at the beginning, in our apartment, and it was no accident. A terrible revelation awaited for me. I found my wife, only in the photo, but still. I wanted to be with her. And my world collapsed. I thought that this was the end of my... Wow, this is the village where I grew up. Engine is on fire. I need to help the man inside urgently. It looks like my parents' home, where we had the fire.
not give up just like that.
I love you, Elizabeth. I felt like I was falling into an abyss of my own life. All the moments in it were flashing by. I hoped for only one thing. That there, I'd be able to see Elizabeth. And I saw her. I did not know if I had woken up from a coma or not. But the feeling that she was near, the warmth of her gaze,
made me feel more alive than any of the living.